This episode is gonna be a doozy. I'm gonna catch some flack for this one because there are some people who are absolutely gonna praise this video and love this video, and some people are gonna be so frustrated and ticked off they're gonna leave me nasty comments down below. But you know what? I don't care. It has to be said. The no-code revolution has arrived, the train is pulling up to the station, and I'm getting on board. I am on board, baby. All right, you heard it. You heard me say it. The no-code revolution is here and I'm on board. I am signed up. I'm a big fan. Let's do it. Let's make websites and applications without touching the code or touching the code as little as possible. I'm down with the less code or the little code revolution as well, but I'm definitely down with the no-code revolution. Now, stick with me. Before we go too far, what is no-code and what does it all mean? What does it all mean? No-code is exactly what it sounds like. It's a way for you to create digital products, websites, applications, mobile applications, desktop applications, without having to touch any code, just having to do something else besides coding, most likely designing, most likely organizing, or administering some information. This is the no-code move. You're able to build stuff and launch products and do stuff without doing the code portion. And I know what you're gonna say, there's lots of questions, so I'm gonna try to answer some of these questions now before we go on any further. What is a no-code tool? Basically, a no-code tool is anything which facilitates you in creating that digital product that you want to create without touching the code. I feel like I already answered this question. Let's move on. Here's the next question that some of you code lovers are going to ask, some of you nerds, some of you developers. Isn't hand coding better? Isn't it more professional? And the answer to that question is definitely maybe. Or maybe not. It really depends on the scenario, the situation, and the person. Let me explain. Hand coding is great. It allows you to get everything done that your knowledge base or your Googling fingers could possibly allow you to do. The sky's the limit. You can create anything with code. You can create a simple HTML website. You can create a backend database. You can create cars that drive themselves on the road if you're Elon Musk. If you want to be the next Elon, get to Mars, you should code. But if you just want to make websites for clients and make a good living doing it, no-code tools might be for you. That's all I'm saying. That's all I'm saying. But will it replace developers? Will it ever fully get rid of them? To that question, I say, definitely not. Definitely not. A good online suit company that can send you a really nice suit with you just plugging in a few measurements on the website, will that ever replace that old-fashioned tailor who can get everything looking just crisp and amazing? Absolutely not, but it has its own place in the world. That's all I'm saying. It has its own place in the world. What no-code tools do I recommend? Which ones am I playing with? Which ones should you try? Well, you should try whatever floats your boat. I'll say that. There's probably a lot on this list that I'm not gonna mention, and that's okay. These are just the ones that I'm really excited about and I wanted to share with you. I've broken these down into a few categories, and the first category that I wanna talk to you about is website development. You wanna build a website, you wanna make it fast, you wanna make it beautiful, you wanna make it code compliant. I have two recommendations for you today. Recommendation number one, I have been using, enjoying, and loving Webflow quite a bit. If you've never used Webflow, it's been out for a while now. It's amazing. It's how to visually design websites and still think like a front-end developer. You think in margin and padding. You think in databases and collections. You think in colors and class names and IDs. You don't have to sacrifice much as a front-end developer to use Webflow. You just have this amazing tool at your disposal that allows you to do that front-end development a little bit quicker, a little bit more seamlessly. The next website builder on my list is also equally absolutely amazing, and that is Editor X. And before you say, wait, isn't that the one by Wix? Yes, it is the one by Wix. Don't judge. Editor X is a huge step in the right direction for Wix. It is a visual website building tool. It's fully featured. It uses modern technology like Flexbox and CSS Grid. It allows you to do things instantaneously that other platforms maybe wouldn't allow you to do. It allows you to drag and drop. It has some of its own features and kind of like flavor, but that flavor tastes really, really good when you're building a website. I have a series coming out soon about how I build a website And I think I did it the whole website in under an hour. It's pretty good. Next up on the list is the mobile front of things. You heard me right. You can build mobile applications without ever touching, you know, Xcode or Swift or whatever, Android Studio. There's a bunch of tools coming out, but there's two specific ones that I'm very, very excited about for building iOS and Android applications. The first one I'm super excited about, and this is Bravo. Bravo is specifically focusing on designers being able to use Figma and set up their file in a certain way and upload that file to the Bravo platform, and it will transform your design into an application. There's a few caveats you have to do, is just kind of tag things a certain way, set up your file a certain way. I can get my application approved in the iOS App Store, in the Google Play Store. I can charge for it. I can do ads. I can do all of that stuff directly from Bravo. It's gonna be pretty good. I'm really excited about it. You're gonna hear more about it from me later because I'm really pumped on it. I know there's a lot of Sketch users out there, and if you're using Sketch and you wanna make mobile applications, you might think about Supernova Studio. Supernova is an application that does a really similar thing as Bravo. It allows you to take your Sketch application and actually move that application into a fully featured mobile prototype. You can get it into the App Store. You can do everything you need to do with it. And it's literally, you don't have to even touch Xcode. It's the same thing. Design file, straight to applications. How are designers allowed to make mobile applications? This is legit. This is scary cool. And so I'm very, very excited about Supernova Studio. All right, I have three more applications to share with you, and these don't really fit in a website or a mobile kind of bucket. The first one I highly recommend is Notion. That's right, Notion. I know you're gonna say, isn't that a note-taking app? Yes, it is. It's a note-taking app, but it's so much more than that. You can set up public workspaces, you can set up FAQs, you can set up mentorship areas, you can set up client portals, you can set up all sorts of stuff. I use it for everything in my life, not only for notes, not only for organizing, but also for databases and data management and all that good stuff. Everything can be in Notion. That's technically a no-code tool. I'm just saying. Next up is Anima. You've probably heard of Anima if you like to do digital design, if you've used Adobe XD or Figma or Sketch. Anima has been there all along. They're a plugin that does so much more than just plug in. It actually plugs in and plays and creates something. So straight from XD or from some of these other design applications, you can literally use Anima to build your website right out of XD or right out of the design tool. So I have my website built just like so. I use Anima, whoop, it's gonna zip it right into a code-based form, and that website will work. You just have to do a few little taps here or there to figure out where everything goes, but I'm telling you, it's a real deal. The last one up on the list is just called Play, and this one is scary how crazy it sounds. This is an application that allows you to design mobile applications from your mobile application. Are we like six layers deep in Inception and I'm Leo DiCaprio trying to figure out who I am? You literally start establishing, setting up all the elements, move things around, size them, tweak them, connect them. I don't know a whole lot about Play, but I know that the idea of a no-code tool should be to make it as accessible as possible to you to create these applications. What's more accessible than this? Than your phone that you always have on you. Well, that's it. That's the no-code revolution, and I am waving the flag of excitement for it. What do you think about no-code tools? Are you on board, or are you still skeptical? Do you love your code and your setup, or are you ready to maybe release it and try something new? Let me know down in the comments. I'd love to hear your thoughts. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to leave a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. I do lots of videos about design and development and maybe no code stuff too. So hit that little bell notification icon so you know when another video like this one comes out. I hope you guys are having an amazing week. I hope you're designing amazing things. I hope you're making amazing things. And I hope you're finding the tools that help you do it with a big smile on your face. I'll see you next time.